good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Neha Iyer, and it takes me great pleasure to welcome you to Raymond Khadi, the story respun. Some hands wield the baton, but some hands just spin an eloquent story. In a weave that could humble the British Empire and a style that could seduce Paris and Milan, spinning a fabric of peace, weaving the colors of joy, crafting the cultures of a land. The thread of the loom meets the tradition of technique. The rawness of cloth meets the precision of hand. The spin of the wheel rhythms the beat of the heart. It's how you arrive at the soul of fashion. On behalf of Raymond, I'd like to thank you for joining us on this very special occasion where Raymond becomes the perfect partner to re-spin the fabric of the nation, Khadi. The hand-spun and hand-woven fabric of India, which is not just a fabric, but a whole movement that promoted a socio-cultural aesthetic and an idea that Indians could be self-reliant. In short, a fabric of substance. Both Raymond and Khadi have an emotional connect and a deep-rooted synergy with India. And Raymond, as the proud Indian textile maker with 92 years of heritage, celebrates this synergy in history by launching Raymond Khadi. We are proud of the heritage where Khadi comes from and strive to maintain it while giving it a contemporary spin to resonate with the fashion of today. Our endeavor is to traverse a journey from the fabric of the nation to fabric of fashion. And with that, ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to call upon the Chief Executive Officer of Lifestyle Business at Raymond, Shri Sanjay Behel, to come up on stage and say a few words, please.
Ladies and gentlemen, a very good evening to all of you. This evening is a tribute to the fabric of nation, which has become the most powerful symbol of self-reliance and captures the pride of young India. I would take this opportunity to welcome our chief guest for the evening, Honorary Minister of State for MSME, Shri Giriraj Singh. Thank you, sir. Thank you very much for gracing the occasion with your presence. Honorary Minister of Revenue, Education, Legislative and Parliamentary Affairs, Government of Gujarat, Shri Bhupendra Singh Chudasama Ji. Thank you very much, sir, for being here. Honorary Member of Parliament, Shri Gopal Shetty Ji. Honorary Member of Legislative Assembly, Maharashtra, Shri Pratap Senik Ji. The Chairman of KVIC, Shri Vinay Kumar Saxena, who has been truly a guardian and a mentor for all of us. So thank you very much, VK Ji. I also extend our heartiest welcome to the guest of honor for the evening, and hold your breath, Srimati Sumitra Gandhi Kulkarni, granddaughter of Mahatma Gandhi. She is an ex-member of parliament who has been living and nurturing the legacy of Mahatma Gandhi every day. She is also an ex-IAS officer. Thank you, madam, for honoring us by being with your gracious presence. I would also like to extend a warm welcome to all the dignitaries, senior government officials, members of our press and the industry, and of course, all our trade partners. Ladies and gentlemen, it was in 1920s that the father of our nation, our beloved Bapuji, proclaimed that Khadi be the embodiment of self-reliance and the indomitable spirit of a whole nation. It was just about the same time in 1925 that Raymond started as an enterprise representing almost similar values of trust, quality, excellence originating from India and yet unmatched globally. Our vision for Raymond Khadi is to, for ease, enable, empower, enhance and excel by co-creating a future envisioned by our honorary Prime Minister, Shri Narendra Modi Ji, to realize the potential of Khadi by making and marketing it for the youth and the seasoned, for the professionals, for free thinkers, for India and the world, truly democratizing Khadi in its reach and in its appeal. On this note, I would like to welcome on the stage the chairman, the custodian of Khadi in the country and the world of KVIC, Shri Vinay Kumar Saxena, to address the August gathering on his vision for this partnership. Shri Saxena ji, thank you.
रेमंड्स और खादी का ये फ्यूजन इसलिए भी ऐतिहासिक है कि आज इसके माध्यम से जो खादी को ग्लोबली ले जाना है, जो हमारे प्रधानमंत्री जी का विजन है, आज उसके लिए जो है हम लोग कदम उठा रहे हैं। जो 1925 में महात्मा गांधी का विजन था, वो आज इस देश के प्रधानमंत्री का विजन है, क्योंकि वो जानते हैं खादी के माध्यम से ही जो है सबसे गरीब व्यक्ति को उसके द्वार पर ही जो है रोजगार दिया जा सकता है। इस एग्रीमेंट से लगभग 3 लाख मैन आवर्स का जो है सृजन होगा, जो अपने में एक बहुत बड़ी बात है। रेमंड्स क्वालिटी के बारे में जाने जाते हैं और अभी उन्होंने खादी के उस कपड़े को जिस तरीके से पेश किया, उससे मुझे लगता है कि खादी का भविष्य अब और भी बहुत उज्ज्वल है। रेमंड्स के इस कन्वर्जन के साथ खादी वैसे भी ग्लोबल हो जाती है, क्योंकि रेमंड्स के जो भी ओवरसीज आउटलेट्स हैं अब वहाँ पे भी खादी मिलने लगेगी। ये सपना माननीय प्रधानमंत्री जी का था और मैं समझता हूँ कि उसी कड़ी में अब सारे कदम हो रहे हैं। मैं एक बार फिर रेमंड्स की टीम को बहुत बहुत मुबारकबाद देता हूँ और आशा करता हूं कि आने वाला समय खादी और रेमंड्स के लिए बहुत उज्जवल होगा। थैंक यू वेरी मच।
थैंक यू सर। और अब मैं बुलाना चाहूंगी श्री भूपेंद्र सिंह चुदासमा जी को, द ऑनरेबल मिनिस्टर फॉर रेवेन्यू एजुकेशन लेजिस्लेटिव एंड पार्लियामेंट्री अफेयर्स फॉर गुजरात गवर्नमेंट। अ लॉयर बाय प्रोफेशन, ही इज अ ब्रिलियंट एग्जाम्पल ऑफ अ रेवोल्यूशनरी लीडर। हिज पैशन फॉर हिज प्रोफेशन स्पीक्स वॉल्यूम्स थ्रू हिज वर्क। In an effort to make India diabetes free by 2030, he has incorporated information about the disease in school syllabi. He also shares a dream with the Prime Minister Narendra Modi ji about expounding the pride he feels for khadi and his vision for seeing khadi as a fabric of fashion. We are honored to have your presence, sir, at this historic moment.
ये कपड़ा नहीं है, कापड़ नहीं है, ये विचार है। और विचार को लेकर नरेंद्र भाई ने बताया था कि हर एक आदमी को जो भी पसंद है वो खादी खरीदनी चाहिए। आपकी एक खरीदी से एक घर चलेगा। वही रास्ते पे मैं चला। मैंने 30 जनवरी गिरिराज जी और सिंघानिया जी, 30 जनवरी को मैंने शिक्षा विभाग के डिपार्टमेंट एज वेल एज ऑल द टीचर्स ऑफ द स्टेट, आई रिक्वेस्टेड ऑल ऑफ देम टू वेयर खादी वंस इन अ वीक। और सब मंगलवार को हम पूरे गुजरात में शिक्षा विभाग से जुड़े हुए तमाम सब लोग खादी पहनते हैं। असर क्या हुआ, 3 महीने में ही 3,75,00,000 सेल में इंक्रीज हुआ। ओनली विद इन 3 मंथ्स आई टुक डिसीजन ऑन 30th of January, फरवरी, मार्च और अप्रैल, 3 महीने में। अब लोग पूछेंगे खादी रेमंड की पहनते हैं कि नहीं पहनते हैं। ये मैं देख रहा हूं विद इन अ ईयर टाइम। अरे यार देखिए यार, इतनी अच्छी खादी मिल रही है, आपने जो पहना है इससे भी अच्छी रेमंड की खादी है। मैं देख रहा हूँ, मुझे याद करना सिंघानिया जी और सक्सेना जी विद इन अ ईयर ऑफ टाइम। और अंत में इस एग्रीमेंट से दोनों को सम्मान मिलता है, खादी को भी, रेमंड से जुड़ने के बाद खादी को सम्मान मिलता है और रेमंड को भी आज खादी जुड़ने से सम्मान मिलता है।
अब मैं बुलाना चाहूंगी श्री गिरिराज सिंह जी को, हु इज द ऑनरेबल मिनिस्टर ऑफ स्टेट फॉर माइक्रो स्मॉल एंड मीडियम एंटरप्राइज गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया। ही इज द मेंबर ऑफ पार्लियामेंट फ्रॉम द नवाडा कॉन्स्टिट्यूएंसी इन द 16th लोकसभा। ही हैज ऑल्सो सर्वड एज अ बिहार कैबिनेट एज कोऑपरेटिव मिनिस्टर एंड एनिमल हस्बेंड्री मिनिस्टर। He is a leader who believes in being ahead of his time. A true leader in all aspects, he not only directs but leads by example. His bold statement of no more red beacon compelled many to stop and think about having a responsibility and taking one. His belief in power to people encouraged many to follow him. Known for his community work and societal responsibility, Shri Giriraj Singh Ji is the inspiration behind driving adoption of khadi as part of your everyday dressing, be it the dress code for cabin crew members of Air India or khadi dress code as school uniforms in various departments with novel designs and cost effectiveness. He has also taken up the cause with governors and chief ministers to use khadi in their offices. A true idealist in every aspect, we're honored to have you here, sir.
हम लोग आज खादी गांधी मोदी जी और रेमंड इन सारे को एक साथ जोड़ दिया है तो इससे जुट गया भारत. इसलिए एक बार भारत का जयकारा लगाना होगा. कॉरपोरेट आज खादी की ओर जा रहा है तो भारत माता की जय भी हमारे प्रधानमंत्री का ये प्रथम मंत्र है. तो आप सभी लगाएंगे भारत माता की. जरा आवाज तेज हो कॉरपोरेट की तरह लगे. जैसा कॉरपोरेट का आर्थिक स्ट्रक्चर है उसी तरह लगे. भारत माता की, भारत माता की, भारत माता की, वंदे वंदे वंदे. हमें झिझक नहीं आनी चाहिए. आज यही झिझक खादी को पीछे ले गया था. केवल मैनचेस्टर के कपड़े का बहिष्कार नहीं करके खादी का शुरुआत की थी गांधी ने. देश स्वराज के साथ साथ आर्थिक स्वराज की एक ताना बाना रचा था. पूरी दुनिया अटल बिहारी वाजपेयी ने कहा था अगली लड़ाई देश का दुनिया में जो लड़ाई होगी वह पानी के लिए लड़ाई होगी. पानी के लिए आज कॉटन का अगर आप लें टेक्सटाइल के क्षेत्र में जो मुझे थोड़ा बहुत ज्ञान है एक मीटर कपड़े को बनाने में लगभग 53 लीटर पानी लगता है. लेकिन यही खादी लेस देन 4 लीटर. एक तरफ आने वाले चुनौतियों में दूसरे तरफ खादी एक ऐसा डिजाइन से उसकी स्पिनिंग होती है कि अभी एक सोशल मीडिया पर वायरल हुआ खादी पहनो कूल कूल महसूस करो खूब वायरल हुआ. इसके स्पिनिंग के जो डिजाइन है एस डिजाइन उस डिजाइन की स्पिनिंग की टेक्नोलॉजी जो है वो जाड़े में गरम और गरम में ठंड. हम एक तरफ हेरिटेज खादी को प्रीमियम प्राइस दे करके शान के साथ हैंड स्पन एंड हैंड वीवन का टैग लगा करके हम अपने कपड़े को पहनेंगे और लेकिन दूसरे तरफ कॉस्ट इफेक्टिव यूजर फ्रेंडली मास प्रोडक्ट. हमें दोनों देखना है. अगर हमने दोनों की ओर हाथ बढ़ाया तो निश्चित रूप से एक नई क्रांति आएगी. जब मैं आपके आर्टिस्ट के साथ या जो फैशन डिजाइनर थे टेक्सटाइल के या उनके साथ जब मैं बात कर रहा था कपड़े में छू रहा था तो लग रहा था कि यही कपड़े मेरे घर में है तो ये लग रहा है बीपीएल फैमिली का कपड़ा आ गया. और वही कपड़ा आपके द्वारा प्रोसेस हो गया तो लग गया कि एपीएल फैमिली का है ऊपर का है. ये आपकी टेक्नोलॉजी का कमाल है. तो आपकी टेक्नोलॉजी हम आगे आपके शोरूम के जिस समय हम लोग घूम रहे थे मैंने अपने चेयरमैन साहब से कहा कि चेयरमैन साहब अब मेरा फोकस होगा गांव में जो हम आर्टिजन को क्लस्टर देते हैं उस क्लस्टर में ऐसे लोगों के टेक्नोलॉजी को इन लोगों के साथ कोलैबोरेट करके हम वहां पहुंचे. आज खादी गांधी और मोदी, ये तीनों को जन जन तक ले जाना, ये संकल्प लेने की जरूरत है, क्योंकि ये इमोशन है कि अगर गांव के गरीबी को मिटाना है तो इसी खादी के द्वारा ही मिटेगा। इसमें अभी मेरा लक्ष्य है कि अभी मेरा जो शेयर है वो 10 times आगे ले जाना और प्रधानमंत्री के सपनों को साकार करना। बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद।
इट टेक्स ग्रेट प्लेजर फॉर मी टू इनवाइट तनिष्ठा चाटर्जी, known as the princess of parallel cinema by the media. Tanishtha has presided many international film juries, including Asia Pacific Screen Awards in Australia, MOVE Film Festival in Belgium. Put your hands together for Tanishtha Chatterjee.
Thank you, Neha, for such a lovely introduction. You look beautiful. Good evening, everybody. A lot has been said by very inspiring people here tonight. So just to take this evening forward, I welcome you all to this beautiful evening of color, vibrancy, and unraveling of a new narrative in fashion. Fashion is a statement. You know, it defines our personality. It allows us to express ourselves. But this evening is not just an ordinary evening of fashion, as we are about to witness the rebirth of a statement made decades ago in a completely new and never seen avatar. And this statement, as you all have realized already, is khadi. You know, when I was young, I used to play this game that many of us must have played. I used to tie a pebble with a thread and just spin it around. And I used to get fascinated by changing the length of the thread all the time, and it would spin beautifully. And my grandma would always give me a metaphor from that imagine if there was no thread, the pebble would just fall. And imagine if there was no pebble, then the thread would lose its meaning. And I think it's very clear what she wanted to tell me about rootedness. It is our rootedness to our culture that can only enhance our contemporary development. And this evening, to talk more about this connect, I would like to invite a very special person who knows no borders, no barriers, no limits, and has defied convention most of us have known. A career that spans across India, America, and Europe, from James Bond, Octopussy, The Bold and the Beautiful, to the major Italian series Sandokan. Please welcome a voting member of the Oscars Academy, knighted by the Italian Republic, whom you've recently seen in Mohenjo-Daro. I guess you've already guessed. Yes, Mr. Kabir Bedi.
Thank you, Tanishtha, for a very lovely introduction. Chief Minister Sahab, Honorable Ministers, Smriti Kulkarni, great-granddaughter of Mahatma Gandhi, my friend Gautam Singhania, who I must congratulate on this brilliant initiative that you have launched, all distinguished speakers and guests, I hope you are now going to be treated to a great example of creativity in khadi and its many forms and uses. And I wish you the best this evening. I believe you have a question for me.
I have lots of questions for you, and I'll call you sir.
If you wish.
Because you are the teacher for me tonight.
Okay.
So, I mean, you've been actually the original actor who made it really big internationally, and people like us like tried to just follow your footsteps.
Thank you.
But in your, you know, span of such a long career and working all over the world, what comes to your mind when you think of khadi?
Khadi, Mahatma Gandhi, the national struggle, self-reliance, so many things. But you know, the story that always brings a smile to my face is when Mahatma Gandhi went to London in 1931 to attend the round table conference that the British government had called on the subject of India's independence. And the king at the time, King George, was throwing a reception for all the delegates. But he didn't want to call Mahatma Gandhi. He said, he doesn't dress properly and his knees show. But his advisor said, sir, it wouldn't be a good idea to exclude him. It doesn't matter, we're having a reception on the lawns of Buckingham Palace. If he comes underdressed, he'll feel cold, he'll leave early, that'll be the end of the matter. You won't feel cold. So Gandhi got his invitation and he went to the reception, stayed the entire length of the evening and had pleasantries with the king. When he came out, journalists asked him, didn't you feel cold on the lawns of Buckingham Palace wearing this? And he said, no, His Majesty wore enough for both of us. So that was Mahatma Gandhi's sense of humor, as well as making a statement by his presence there.
Well, I think that was one of the most daring statements he made at that roundtable conference. And I would call that the essence of coolness.
Yes, cool, and it's certainly a statement. You know, in India, khadi is much more than a fabric. It's a movement that Gandhiji started in 1918 when he came back from South Africa, because it was a movement for economic independence of the poorest of the poor. And the point of Gandhiji's whole initiative was to stop the exploitation that was happening, because the British would buy cotton very cheaply here, send it to England, to the mills of Lancashire and Manchester, etc., have it milled there, brought back as woven cloth, and then sell it at an exorbitant price in India. So this was really a program of self-reliance, of self-government. And so khadi has an enormously deep significance beyond the beauty of the fabric itself, in terms of the being woven into the ideals of the freedom struggle.
So each revolution of this spinning wheel is poetic and it inspires all kinds of artists. So tonight what you're about to witness is a Kathak performance by Seema Mehta and her troupe Chandam. I know what you're thinking. They'll wear, you know, a khadi anarkali and just dance to the usual bandish, but that's not it. This is a very unique choreography that you're about to witness, creating rhythmic patterns that replicate the sounds of the handloom equipment using footwork, recitation, and clapping. So ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together to embrace Raymond Khadi, the story respun. Enjoy.
Thank you.
Clearly you're a history student. Like, you don't need this. Like, I have to look, right? But I'm a student of chemistry.
Any chemistry? I like chemistry too.
I will ask you something that's related to both probably. But I've always been curious about the past. And I think the past, the present, and the future, they always overlap, don't you think so? So now putting some things together, I wanted to ask you about this whole indigo, you know, prints and fabrics in its historical context. Would you throw some light on that?
Yes, you know, we associate khadi with Gandhiji, and Gandhiji is also associated with indigo, because when he came from South Africa, one of the first big struggles he began, his nonviolent satyagraha, was in Champaran, in Bihar, where peasants were forced to grow indigo against their will, and this indigo was then taken by the British at very cheap prices and taken abroad for dyeing and all the things you do with indigo. So this is one of Gandhiji's earliest victories, indigo. And therefore, it's natural that things go in certain cycles in history, certain things repeat. And if indigo has come back as a color and fashion today, it's probably has its roots somewhere there. Yeah. But you know, clothes, as you saw in khadi, don't have to be the conventional clothes that people wear. It can be a whole new dimension. It is a brilliant example of the kind of creativity that can be brought into the field of khadi, for which one must salute Raymond Group for all the creativity that they're using to bring traditional fabrics in a brand new avatar.
And actually, Raymond has undertaken design intervention with many khadi weavers, sharing technical expertise with the artisans to develop khadi and weave it into a new avatar.
That's bringing together tradition and modernity, which is why the slogan, Raymond Khadi, the story respun. Because fusing the brilliance of tradition with the techniques of the modern world, a wonderful new khadi is emerging in a whole new incarnation. And I think you're going to see some examples of khadi in the mood indigo in the minutes that follow. I hope you enjoy that too. Thank you.
I would personally also, I'm looking forward to that. Enjoy.
What a brilliant medley of looks that khadi has. It's wonderful to see that kind of creativity used on a fabric that's so traditional.
Yeah, it was a beautiful collection. I want it from my wardrobe.
You should.
Well, yeah, do I have it?
Don't let anything get in the way. You know, I tell you, I mean, my parents were part of the freedom movement. My mother was a handpicked satyagrahi of Mahatma Gandhi. There's a book on her on Amazon if you want to check it out. She wore khadi. And I had a lot of respect for that. And so did my father, both freedom fighters. But when I was in college in Delhi, one of our favorite hangouts used to be the Khadi Emporium on Janpath, where they had this wonderful cafe called Bankura, where we'd go and sit and chat, etc. And lots of poets, writers, artists, composers, creative types would come and sit there in their khadi. And these people were dismissed as the jholawalas, you know. Jholawalas wear khadi. That whole perception has changed completely. Because today, it is an incredible fashion statement to make. And given the fact that this traditional fabric has now combined with the modern technology of Raymond, it's an entire new generation, an entire new reinvention of khadi that's happening, which will take khadi to levels not seen before in the history of India in terms of its export potential as well. So I'm very respectful of khadi, very enamored of khadi, and I believe in its great future as well, because it's one of those natural fabrics that's cool in summer, warm in winter. It can be wool, it can be cotton, it can be silk. It has many, many expressions.
Yes, and it's us. It's us.
It is us.
It's us, and I think that is why it is only right that a brand like Raymond, which has over 90 years of legacy and rich heritage, enhances this journey of this wonderful fabric that, like, embeds centuries of culture and tradition.
Absolutely, absolutely. And I think what we are seeing today is a whole new movement. One movement was started by Gandhiji, a modern movement is happening. But khadi is not just something that Gandhiji started. It's a traditional fabric that goes back centuries. Yuan Sang, the Chinese traveler, chronicled this in the 6th century. Marco Polo spoke of it in the 12th century. And so it has been the bedrock of India and India's khadi production for centuries. So it's something we really have to see as part of our heritage. It's possible that used, I don't know how many thousand years ago. So bringing that ancient fabric into a modern world is a marvelous thing that's happening.
And I think that's why Raymond Khadi's slogan is the story respun. So let's see how Raymond has managed to successfully reinvent the way we see khadi now while retaining the richness of its ethnicity. You know, I feel that the West is always envious of the colors and the vibrancy that our country actually has to offer. Because, you know, when you travel, what do you see there? You see black, white, gray, and sometimes maybe beige. But you see a range of different colors, probably because, you know, the weather conditions and the bright sun in our country really allows that. Don't you think that, you know, we have so much to celebrate in terms of colors?
Yes, what I can say is that our fabrics certainly reflect all the colors of the rainbow. If you go to places like Rajasthan and South and Kerala and Bengal, and in fact everywhere across India, there's the most amazing colors that you see. And those colors are reflective of our festivals, of our celebrations, of Holi, of just the bright spectrum of life that is now also being reflected in the uses of khadi, and that's what I hope you'll see something of in the ethnic manifestation of khadi that you're about to see.
Well, see you after this.
Hope you enjoy that too. I regard the sari as the most complete woman's dress possible. It conceals, it reveals, it's sexy, it's conservative, it's everything and anything you want it to be. And then when you combine it with the colors and the weave and the radiance of khadi, it requires yet another great dimension. In India, we know all about saris. In India, we know all about khadi. But combining the two in a whole new way is what we are going to discover and discovering. It's going to be a very exciting voyage of discovery. And then there's a question of taking khadi abroad and making it more global, more international. And I think that's what the next exposition is all about. And I think I'd like to say that this event has a very special meaning for me because I have for years saluted the work of the Khadi Gramadyog and the work people have done in Khadi. When I was shooting in Mysore with the Italian film unit, they said, we want to shop a little. And I took them to the Khadi Gramadyog there. They cleaned it out like locusts. The first five people went, they bought armloads back. The rest saw them, they all came, they cleaned out the store, there were no supplies left. That is the attraction of khadi potentially for an international market. And that is the next big step. And that's what the next part of the show will reflect. Before leaving, I really want to read a poem that Sarojini Naidu wrote on the Indian weaver. She said, weavers weaving at break of day, why do you weave a garment so gay? Blue as the wing of a halcyon, blue as the wing of halcyon wild, we weave the robes of a newborn child. Weavers weaving at fall of night, why do you weave a garment so bright? Like the plumes of a peacock, purple and green, we weave the marriage veils of a queen. That's from Sarojini Naidu. Thank you and good night.
But the men in the audience
show continues.
Need not be disappointed. To bring a sense of freshness to this beautiful organic khadi, Raymond Design Studio has also worked on a wide array of khadi blends and styles, expanding across a contemporary gentleman's wardrobe with suits, jackets, shirts, and trousers. And every design is at par with global fashion trends.
A modern look for a modern world.
Ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together for our guest of honor, Srimati Sumitra Gandhi Kulkarni ji, and the chairman and managing director of Raymond Group, Sri Gautam Hari Singhania. She belongs to one of the most iconic families in India. She describes her grandfather as someone who taught her to be fearless, inheriting a lineage so strong, one which made the British quit India without a drop of blood being shed. Born to Sri Ramdas Gandhi, Mohandas Karamchand Gandhi's son, it's a matter of great honor that we have amongst us tonight Srimati Sumitra Gandhi Kulkarni ji as guest of honor. I request Sri Gautam Singhania ji to present our token of respect to Srimati Sumitra Gandhi Kulkarni ji.
दोस्तों, मैं इस शहर में आई और इस कार्यक्रम में शामिल हो रही हूँ क्योंकि मेरे जमाई जो हैं उनका अनुरोध था। और आप जानते हैं कि भारतीय समाज में जमाई का कितना बड़ा स्थान होता है। वो हमारी बेटी के सुख के एकमात्र प्रतीक होते हैं, इसलिए उनके अनुरोध को मैं टाल नहीं सकती थी। मगर मैं ये भी जानती हूँ कि मेरी कोई विशेष योग्यता नहीं है कि मैं आप सब लोगों के सामने खड़े हो करके किसी भी विषय पर बात करूं जो आपको अच्छी भी लगे, आपका ध्यान भी रहे और शायद आपकी स्मृति में भी रह सके। आज आप सब लोगों ने खादी की चर्चा की, खादी की विशेषता बताई। ये बहुत ही खुशी की चीज़ है कि अंततः आखिर में खादी की पहचान बढ़ गई, जिससे मगर खादी की एक जो विशेष पहचान है वो ये है कि वो अपने देश का कपड़ा है, ये एक बात मान्य है। हाथ से बना है, हाथ से काटा हुआ है, ये भी बहुत बड़ी चीज़ है। मगर उससे भी आगे खादी की एक दूसरी कंडीशन को मैं क्या कहूँगी, एक दूसरा पहलू भी है या उसकी कंडीशन होती है कि जो काटने वाली औरत है उसको उस दिन का खर्चा उसका निकलना चाहिए। जब तक कि ऐसा न मुआवजा मिले हर काटने वाली को, तब तक उसका कोई उपयोग नहीं है। वो खादी ज़रूर है और हम खुशी खुशी पहनेंगे, मगर खादी का एक नियम है कि एक दिन का जितना उस कत्तिन या काटने वाली औरत को जितना दिन का खर्चा है उतना उसको मिलना चाहिए। जब वो मिलेगा तभी खादी कहलाएगी और इसलिए वो खादी महंगी होती है। मैं जानती हूँ कि आज के समाज में लोगों को खादी पसंद तो है क्योंकि बहुत उसके अंदर इंडिविजुअलिटी है, उसके रंग, उसका व्यवहार, उसका कपड़ा सब कुछ अच्छा लगता है। मगर बहुत से लोग मुझे कहते हैं कि भाई बहुत महंगा है, आप मानेंगे नहीं। मेरे पड़ोस में एक महिला रहती थी और मैं हमेशा कहती थी कि हाँ, हमारी दुकान खादी भंडार में है, वहाँ जाएंगे, वहाँ से मैं कपड़ा खरीदूंगी। जब वो मेरे साथ आई खादी भंडार अहमदाबाद में देखने के लिए, तो तो उनको लगा कि शायद मैं ये भंडार मेरी खुद की संपत्ति है और मुझे उस कपड़ा खरीदने के अंदर थोड़ा सा मुआवजा मिलेगा, थोड़ा सा रिबेट मिलेगा। मैंने कहा कि नहीं, ये तो हमारी दुकान ज़रूर है क्योंकि हम यहीं से कपड़ा खरीदते हैं, बाकी इसका भाव, इसका जो चीज़ है उसको कोई बदल ही नहीं सकता है। तो खादी की ये विशेषता है कि खादी हम अपना कितना ही पहने, कुछ भी पहने, मगर उसका बुनियादी नियम ये है कि उस काटने वाली औरत को दिन भर का उसका खर्चा निकलना चाहिए और जब वो निकलेगा और वो मुआवजा दिया जाएगा तब इस वो खादी कहलाएगी। इसीलिए खादी बहुत महंगी गिनी जाती है क्योंकि एक कत्तिन को उसका दिन भर का मुआवजा देना ये कोई छोटी मोटी बात नहीं है, और ख़ास करके आज के ज़माने में। तो इसलिए खादी का महत्व है कि वो लोगों को हाथ से काटना, हाथ से बुनना सिखाती है, मगर ईमानदारी पूर्वक उसको दिन का मुआवजा भी मिलता है। ये विशेषता कभी भूलनी भी नहीं चाहिए। और जब हम खादी खरीदते हैं तो हमारा ये कंट्रीब्यूशन को अंग्रेजी हिंदी में कहेंगे, ये हमारा सहयोग होगा उसके अंदर कि हम खादी खरीद रहे हैं तो हम समाज के अंदर उसकी स्थिति और उसको बुनने वाले, उसको सीने वाले, उसको काटने वाले, उन सब लोगों की आवश्यकता को ध्यान में रख करके ही हम खादी का उपयोग करते हैं। इसलिए खादी का महत्व है ये समझ लेना। कभी आजकल बहुत ज़बरदस्त फैशन है खादी के कपड़े पहनना, खादी के स्टाइल में चलना, मगर अंततः वही खादी है जहाँ पर ये ध्यान दिया जाएगा कि वो काटने वाली औरत को दिन का खर्चा, और आजकल भाव बढ़ गए, हर चीज़ की ज़िंदगी की आवश्यकताओं के लिए पैसे बहुत देने पड़ते हैं, तो उसको ध्यान रख करके खादी का खर्चा भी बढ़ जाएगा। खादी के बारे में आप अपने दिल में दो चीज़ का ध्यान रखें कि एक तो वो बहुत आजकल बहुत फैशन में है, विशेषता लगती है कि हमने एक विशेष तरह का कपड़ा पहना है, मगर उसके साथ साथ हम समाज को भी सहारा देते हैं और उस चीज़ को स्वीकार करते हैं कि जो समाज के लोग, हर तरह के लोगों को एक स्तर से रहने का हक है। तो ये खादी का प्रतीक है और वो जो कोई भी खादी का उपयोग करते हैं या खादी के बारे में विश्वास रखते हैं वो उसमें सहयोग देते हैं। बहुत धन्यवाद।
I now request Mr. Singhania to give us his vote of thanks.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I think today we stand on a very historic day where Raymond, along with KVIC, has come in its first step in its cooperation towards a big change in the way khadi will be perceived in the future. Let me just start off by saying that this association was thought of less than 6 months ago when KVIC chairman and us had a discussion, and I assured him, I said, Raymond will do everything possible to change and make khadi into a fashion item. Khadi has always been perceived, and I'm not saying it is, it's always been perceived as a common man's fabric. Raymond has always been perceived as a high fashion fabric. And where the two of them come together, I think we have created a very unique partnership of how we can blend our Indian artisans who make khadi, handmade and handspun, with Raymond's design knowledge and technology knowledge, to create a win-win partnership that is not only good for KVIC, but also good for the nation. I want people to say that, oh, is this only available in India? And I will say yes. I'm not going to take too much time, as it's been a long evening, but I just want to say one last thought. Many years ago, a press reporter once interviewed me and said, you know, so-and-so brand abroad does bespoke suiting. And what are your views on bespoke suiting? To which I replied, I said, we've been doing bespoke suiting since the day we started our business. Bespoke suiting is basically custom tailoring. But today, I will have the pride and pleasure to say that not only do we do handmade suits and garments, but we have added hand-woven fabrics and hand-woven yarn. This is a matter of pride. And I can now say truly that we will be the only company in the world that takes bespoke to the next level. Thank you very much.